If your control system is fortunate enough to have what's called BES or batch execution system functionality, then you won't need anything on the PI side to generate your batch records. The batch records and all the hierarchy and everything will be generated by the control system, and we'll just have to read a journal file through one of our special interfaces. However, most people don't have that luxury. Most people need a mechanism or functionality in order to generate their event framing data. And for that, we give you the PI Batch Generator interface. It's commonly referred to in OSI as PIBaGen. PIBaGen watches what are called trigger tags or active points. And when that active point tells us so, that means a batch has started. We'll watch that, and that same point will tell us when it ends. And that will allow us to create batches and unit batches and PI batches and all that good stuff. The PIBaGen or batch generator interface can monitor multiple active points for sub batches and unit batches and all that. So you can have a lot of batches going on your PI server as you're collecting data. The PIBaGen is normally run as a service. Now, this is installed as a service on your system, and if I were to go into settings and control panel and administrative tools and services, the services applet is in a different place on different operating systems, but I'm on a XP system. I'm going to scroll down until I find batch generator interface, and you'll see that it is installed, but it is set to manual even though the other PI systems are automatic. And I will have to change this to automatic before I start this up. Now, like every other interface, we have to make sure the interface is configured correctly, and that is done by looking at the interface installation folder. By default, that's the PIPC interfaces and PIBaGen folder. So we would have to look in that folder and configure the interface before we were to start it up. If we didn't, we would get an error message and it wouldn't start. And we're going to have to look in the, if we got error messages, they would be in the PIPC.log file. In all the information for PIBaGen is stored in the PI module database. In order to configure the batch generator interface, we're going to have to do a couple of things first. And the very first thing you should do is you should check the batch file for the interface and make sure it's configured correctly. And I'll show you what I mean by that. I'll open up my computer and I'll go to Program Files, PIPC, and Interfaces. If you remember, this is where all of our interfaces are installed on the PI server or on any machine. And you'll see the PIBaGen folder. And what I want to do is I want to check this batch file and make sure it's set up correctly. And what you're going to find is that the host name is set to localhost, and that's because we don't know what type of or what the name or location of your server is. Now, localhost used to work on older versions of the PI server, but since the platform release 1 and the high availability functionality, localhost is not allowed anymore. So I'm going to need to put a host name in there for my machine. So I'm going to change localhost to train 56. That's the name of this machine. Now, in many cases, this file is going to be read-only, so you may have to right-click and select properties and make sure that read-only is not one of the attributes checked. I think I've looked at this before, and so I took the read-only marker off it, but I think by default that it's going to come read-only. So you want to change that, and then you're going to want to save your file. So you're going to want to save your batch file. And now that I know the batch file is correct, we can try to start it up through our services applet. So I can go to the services applet, and I can go to batch generator interface, and I can select properties. I want to make sure this operates on an automatic basis from now on, so I'll change that, and I will start the interface. And if I want to check to see if it started up correctly, I can go back to my PIPC folder, look inside the DAT or data folder and find the PIPC.log file. I will scroll all the way to the bottom of that file because these files are appended, and you can see that my interface did see the correct server. It did see my server. It did start up. It did open a connection. And what it says is it could not find the module OSI PIBaGen. This is because there's one more step to configuring this interface, and that is to set a module name in the System Manager tools. So if I go into my System Manager tools, I connect to my PI server, expand batch, and go to Batch Generator. You'll see that there is unit batch, sub batch, PI batch, and interface. You will need to configure the interface section here in order for this to work.